chicane here at Lime Rock for the 24 Barber Saab competitors. And the other big first for Rob Wilson or Justin Bell from Great Britain, for that matter, Robbie Buell of the United States. If they can become victorious today, they will be the first two-time winner in 1989 as we move to event number four. With me is Bill Adam. How about this competition?
Well, it just keeps getting better and better all the time. We're seeing very serious European participation, and for a very good reason. Not only do they like the competition, but there is a $100,000 enhancement fund for the winner of this series. Each of these three fellas wants very badly to win, and I think our camera being on board one of the cars, it's going to give us great shots of just what they're seeing.
The race today is the TDK Challenge, and the man on the pole is Justin Bell of Great Britain. With him right now is Mike Joy.
Justin Bell brings a famous racing name to the front row here at Lime Rock Park. What will you be thinking in a few minutes as you head down this front straightaway and look under the bridge toward turn one?
Pretty nervous right now, but when the car starts moving, you come over all calm and you try to concentrate on what you're doing.
Just having your coach alongside here, is that a help, or is that maybe, does that make you a little more nervous?
More nervous, yeah. No, I mean, I'm just looking forward to hopefully putting up a strong few opening laps and get the first corner over with and then just pace out like in qualifying.
His father, of course, world endurance champion, Daytona Le Mans winner, Derek Bell, most everybody's favorite endurance driver. Well, what kind of coaching have you given him about Lime Rock Park? You have a lot of experience here.
Yeah, well, really, the most important thing is to be neat and tidy around here because it's very bumpy on the extremities when you go anywhere near falling off the road. And the most important thing for him is he's got all the talent, I mean, enough to do successfully. The whole thing is up to him. All I can do really is just guide him a little bit. I mean, he's the one behind the wheel, and I can't do much for him, really.
Okay, Derek Bell, son Justin, on the pole.
And an aerial view of the very challenging 1.54-mile road circuit really doesn't show how difficult this track is. Because of elevation changes and hidden corners, it's very difficult. But this spot right here is the real difficulty. Normally a very fast climbing corner, this year we have a new chicane inserted to slow down the speeds and increase the safety. Extremely difficult, very, very challenging for the Barber Saab cars.
In the front row is Justin Bell from England, the Miami winner, and it is rather Rob Wilson on the pole, the Miami winner, and Justin Bell, winner at West Palm, alongside. In row two is Robbie Buell from Grosse Pointe, Michigan, the winner at Road Atlanta, and Brian Till, who was second at West Palm, starts on the outside of that row. Row three is Bernard Santel, and with him comes Kuhnwalder. That's in row three. Then going to row four, you have Brian Boner and Bob Ancona. In row five for today's action, there you have John Cochran, who's a very fast driver in this competition, and Brian Till out of Houston, Texas. For row six today, Bill Adams is there. Any relation to you?
I don't know.
And Bob Reed from Millbrook, New York. Row seven starts Jeff Boyce in the number 12 car, and Bob Dotson is on the outside of that row. In row eight, it's Jim Pace, and Steve Gambino gets a starting assignment in that row. Row nine today will be Steve Hines and Bruce McQuesten. Row 10 is Matt Blevins, and Chris McAdam is back there as well. In row 11, it is Jeff Butts and Ian O'Flattery from New Haven, Connecticut. Going to row 12, George Sutcliffe is there, and alongside is Adam Eunice of Miami, Florida. 24 cars as we get set for the start, warming up the tires a bit on these 2-liter Saab-powered machines, preparing for competition. Looks like quite a dance. We'll be back for the start of the TDK Challenge from Lime Rock Park in just a moment.
ESPN Speed World coverage of the Barber Saab TDK Challenge is brought to you by your local Saab dealers, who invite you to test drive one of the most intelligent cars ever built. By Quaker State Motor Oil, the big Q stands for quality, always has, always will. And by Busch Beer, the beer with a taste as smooth as its name.
Most car accidents happen in a showroom. People buy the wrong car. They want a car as quick as a Saab, as roomy as a Saab, as safe as a Saab, as reasonably priced as a Saab. But they don't test drive a Saab. Don't buy the wrong car. Visit your Saab dealer for a test drive. It's fun, it's free, and there's no risk involved.
Heading for the mountains, I'm just looking for a buddy. right. Quaker State engines don't know when to quit.
Quaker State is quality engineered to exceed every single American, European, and Japanese car maker's U.S. requirements for maximum engine protection.
So pistons are protected from friction mile after mile. Valves are protected from wear year in, year out.
That's why Quaker State engines run strong and run long.
Quaker State engines don't know when to quit.
The big Q stands for quality. Always has, always will.
Let's talk hoses. Water in, water out. Want to know anymore? Ask Ace. That's what I do.
This 70-foot reinforced garden hose is $8.99, and you can store it on this Ames hose reel for just $14.88.
Hey, Ace is a place for me.
Perfect day for racing at Lime Rock Park in New England. Not even a possible glimmer of rain today. 82 degrees and a tremendous throng gathered here as the TDK Challenge comes down to the line in the Barber Saab Series. It's race number four.
Ian, Skip Barber has to be so pleased with what has happened to this series. It just keeps growing and getting better and better all the time. And here it is, perfect day right in his own backyard.
This is the course upon which the Skip Barber School originates.
This is coming downhill, and they're going awfully slowly right now. I think maybe the starter has spoken to them and said a very slow, gentle start to try and keep the field boxed as much as possible, keep all their speeds relatively equal.
Drivers in four nations. This competition, $100,000 bonus to the overall winner of the Barber Saab Series in 1989 as we get set to clip them off. And there, from Robbie Buell's car number 7, you have a picture of the front row. That's the Clarion Onboard Camera, Clarion Corporation of America, bringing you these exciting pictures as we come down for a start. And look at this start, four wide as they come to the line.
Just tremendous. And look at this, an outbreaking duel going into turn one. And I think, yes, he did. Rob Wilson grabbed the lead.
Wilson jumping out in front. The Big Ben headed for the S's. Everybody safely away. Englishman Wilson out in front. Justin Bell to second. Bobby Buell third as they come around in the first lap.
Really just an excellent start by Wilson. Sensational. He's pulling out quite a good lead here on lap one. Now they have to be very careful with these tires. They are on racing tires, and the tires will not perform perfectly until they get up to temperature. You can see the cars wiggling a little bit. They're squiggling as the tires are trying to get good traction. They're not quite ready to race really hard yet.
How long does it take those tires to come up?
They can probably do it within two laps, but right now it's a very dicey situation where they feel that they're almost driving on the brakes. The car will be a little bit twitchy for them.
$8,500 to win this race, a $100,000 bonus.
Whoop!
A little trouble further back. They come down the main straightaway and back for turn one. Watching Wilson out in front, Bell in second. Buell falling back. There you see Santel just in front of him now in third. Buell falling to fourth. Let's stay with this in-car camera. Watch them tussle around this mile-and-a-half, eight-turn facility.
Now, this is really a rare opportunity to be on board one of these cars and watch it. Look at the front suspension just deflecting from the bumps, and watch the driver on the steering wheel. Watch his hands, watch the wheel positions, constantly fighting these little slides. There we're going through
chicane.
That's a chicane. Right to the edge of the track, and full throttle acceleration right here. You can also just see the tachometer needle every once in a while underneath the rim of the steering wheel.
Santel just in front as they head downhill underneath that bridge for a moment. Coming on the main straightaway and right by our vantage point at the start-finish line. Fastest part of the course right here. How fast for Barber Saab at this point?
These cars should be up to about 125 miles an hour. Of course, they're going very deep into turn one before they're on the brakes.
Clarion camera giving us incredible pictures here in the early going. This Barber Saab round four, 1989 championship series. Three different winners in three races thus far in 89. Looks like we might have a repeat at the present time. Yep, one car off down in turn number one.
Car number 11, it's Jim Pace. Just decided to do a little farming, but you can see there is a mark on the car. It's a good wide area of track to go off. If you're going to make a mistake, perfect place to do it. He hasn't damaged the car at all.
Jackson, Mississippi's 28-year-old Jim Pace back underway in this Barber Saab Series. Coming around in the third lap. Robbie Buell back to fourth. Ian Ashley of Cambridge, England, running fifth. Coon Walter drops into the sixth position. And Brian Bonner is seventh. Brian Till is in eighth. Here are those leaders coming by for another lap.
You can watch Rob Wilson as he comes down the straight. He's just weaving back and forth to try and break any little bit of draft that makes sense, much like what the Indy cars do. Oh, and a power slide coming out. No, eventually.
That looks like Williams Grove.
Dale Earnhardt, the car. He could overheat his rear tires by doing that consistently, so he has to be very careful and keep it smooth. Probably what he's doing is taking a look in the mirror. He's aware that... Oh, and there's a car.
Off and in trouble. Landed right in the brook.
But you can see the skid marks right through the grass so that the water just stopped him. That's turn two right there.
$36,000 at stake in this event. Continuing to lead, Rob Wilson tried to get an ID on that man that went off and took the early shower. Went to the showers early. Here's Justin Bell in that second spot. Switzerland, Santel running third in the red car, number 20.
It appears right now, Ken, that, and again, he's sliding the car a lot more with the back end, where Justin is driving the car through the corner more. But watching Justin's car come down the main straight, maybe we can watch it again next lap, it looks like he's got a little too much rear brake on the car. The back end is dancing around more than the car either ahead or behind.
That's one of the few adjustments they can make, is the braking area. 97.6 miles per hour in the last lap. Here we are back to that brand new and very tight chicane as Wilson manages to manipulate it very nicely, stays out in front. Let's go to Mike.
Ken, the start here was one of the strangest we've seen at Lime Rock Park. The pace car driver came down pit road with his hands palms up like, where were the cars? Justin Bell's dad, and he knows about these drag race starts, told his son, bring them really slow down the hill, slow until the front straightaway, and start the race on your terms. Well, unfortunately, his terms weren't quite as favorable as Wilson's, who got that jump on the outside, but that's why they were so slow and so late coming down to the flag.
Was the thundering herd instinct as they came to the stripe.
I think that's the last time Justin listened to Derek on that one.
We'll be back with more of the TDK Challenge from Lime Rock Park in just a moment.
If you like beef, you're going to love Shoney's Beef Tips. Prepared with fresh sautéed onions and green peppers or mushrooms. You also get your choice of fluffy baked potato or crispy French fries, Shoney's special dinner bread, plus Shoney's famous soup, salad, and fruit bar. For the best sirloin beef tips, now at a special price, it's Shoney's.
Should have bought my truck at the Motor Mile.
Problem?
Well, I thought I'd save some money by buying it here.
Yeah?
Every time I take it in for servicing, they keep it for days. This time their heat and air man's out. His wife's having a baby. Last time, my part got lost on the bus.
When you need your truck.
Right.
You should go on the Motor Mile like I did.
Yeah, right.
Airport Motor Mile. The right place to do business in East Tennessee.
They're called the dynamic duo in Formula One racing. Alain Prost and Ayrton Senna continue their battle toward the championship at the Grand Prix of Canada, Sunday afternoon at 5 Eastern on ESPN.
We're back with you once again, Lime Rock Park, Connecticut, with Bill Adam. I'm Ken Squier, Mike Joy, trackside. A great battle going on for first place. Rob Wilson of Brentwood, England, trying to be the first man in 1989 to win two main events, fighting off Justin Bell, who's set on the pole. Bernard Santel of Switzerland is maintaining third. Robbie Buell of Grosse Pointe, Michigan is fourth. Cambridge, England's Ian Ashley is in fifth. And California's Nick Kuhnwalder maintains sixth, while Ridgefield, Connecticut's Bill Ancona is in seventh position. The battle is here on the point. Bill Adam.
And we can see that Justin Bell has closed up quite a bit on Rob Wilson. He's driving very, very smoothly. Rob may be overheating his tires just a tiny bit. Watch as they come down the straight here into turn one. You'll see him now. He's winding from the right to the left and the back. See him check his mirrors? He wants to know just where Justin is because he knows there might be a good passing attempt here.
Justin Bell found a pothole there that chucked him off to the left side. Bell stays one car length back through the big bend. Turn one coming for the S's. Dramatic racing here at Lime Rock Park. Always great racing, a track that favors a driver who really has some style.
You have to be very smooth here. A lot of the secret of Lime Rock is carrying momentum, and you don't want to lose it if at all possible. And you really wanted to stay into this battle. Just let it flow.
Here's a battle for sixth position. A little further back as you watch Nick Kuhnwalder in that sixth position. Bill Ancona. It's East Coast versus West Coast at the present time. Now
Now you're back with Buell in fourth place. Those three leaders drawing away from him a bit. Remember that Buell has won a race this year. Here he is through that chicane. Our Clarion onboard camera giving us tremendous pictures as they loop downhill beneath the bridge.
And you saw the back of the car slide out quite a bit there. That's something that he doesn't want to do, or he's going to overheat his tires.
Big ski run there. This battle for first place is a dandy. Scrapping on the outside, trying to move through with Justin Bell and just barely missing. They're side by side. Look at, they tangle. Off they go. Into the grass goes the car that had made the big move out there.
No, that was Rob Wilson on the grass. He definitely has a broken right front wheel. He'll be out, but Justin Bell's wing is hurt.
Remember that Wilson had been leading. Buell right behind them. Now he's taking a shot at Justin Bell with that damaged wing.
That minor little off-course excursion by Justin has cost him a lot on the leader right now. Here's a replay of it. Now watch on the outside of the corner. That's Rob Wilson right on the outside. There's the contact, and look at his wheel. Right front wheel is bent. He's lost total steering control, and I think it has broken the steering arm.
Leader goes away. The new leader in the event, Santel, stays in front. The story is second place for Justin Bell with an injured car. Continues in second under heavy pressure now from Robbie Buell, the winner last time out.
You know, and perhaps, Ken, that wing isn't really hurting him too much. He's got part of it bent up, but then the outside part is bent far steeper than it originally was. So maybe he's losing a bit on one part of the wing but regaining it with the outer edge.
Riding with Robbie Buell as Bell bounces off the curb. This track gets a lot of weather, and you can see that it's quite a pounding you take, an inch and a half, inch and three quarters off the ground. Closing it again, Grosse Pointe, Michigan's Buell. Here he is through the chicane. Great pictures from our Clarion onboard camera as he tries to close up on second place man Justin Bell.
Really excellent. You can see exactly how closely matched these cars are. The Skip Barber mechanics do a really fine job keeping it very close.
Look. Here we are. Let's stay right here for just a second as they come down that line and come into turn number one. And again, Buell tries, and you can see for just a moment that Justin Bell took an extra cut to get into turn number one.
Justin did get in very, very deep. And again, the back end of the car just snapped out a little bit as the rear end lost traction.
Car number seven. Robbie Buell stays right there in third spot, challenging Justin Bell in a dandy scrap for second place. Ian Ashley remains fourth. Bill Adam has come to fifth position, the Richmond, Virginia driver.
I'm doing well.
And sixth is Nick Kuhnwalder from Encinitas, California. Running seventh from Palm Beach, John Cochran. And from Linfield, Massachusetts, Brian Bonner now moves into eighth. Jim Reed up to ninth. And running tenth is Jeff Boyce. Here's the story, right here, second place.
Well, it appears that wing is not really hurting Justin too much at all. And you can see as it comes towards us, that outer edge is bent up quite a bit, so he must be getting pretty good downforce with it.
Clock to the 120.
Again, Robbie, he's trying.
Is Justin throwing him the dummy there? 97-mile-an-hour lap last time by.
They're really running quickly right now.
We'll continue to follow this championship battle at Lime Rock in the Barber Saab Series, the TDK Challenge Race, in a moment.
Most car accidents happen in a showroom. People buy the wrong car. They want a car as quick as a Saab, as roomy as a Saab, as safe as a Saab, as reasonably priced as a Saab. But they don't test drive a Saab. Don't buy the wrong car. Visit your Saab dealer for a test drive. It's fun, it's free, and there's no risk involved.
So you think you've got big athlete's foot problems, like that annoying itching, terrible cracking, or that awful burning. Well, Bigfoot problems call for Bigfoot relief from Desinex.
Desinex stops the painful itching, cracking, and burning of athlete's foot fast.
And Desinex guarantees you'll be satisfied or your money back.
Money back?
That's right, your money back.
Desinex, the number one cure for athlete's foot.
Quaker State Track Facts are brought to you by Quaker State Motor Oil. The big Q stands for quality. Always has, always will.
The whole idea behind the Barber Saab Pro Series is equally prepared cars in order to showcase driving ability. But there are certain adjustments that a driver can make to his car in order to customize it to his individual driving style. One of the things he can play with is the car's aerodynamics, specifically the front and rear wings. The front airfoil is adjustable from 0 degrees or flat up through 10 degrees, while the two-part rear airfoil is adjustable through 40 degrees of arc. The idea is to find the perfect balance in your wings. Too much wing and your car sticks like glue through the turns, but you lose straight line speed because of drag. While too little wing gives you maximum straight line speed, but your car is a real handful in the turns. It's finding that perfect balance in the wings, front and rear, that can make the difference between winning and losing.
We'll take a look at this battle that continues. Aerodynamic contest through the chicane and back into the faster part of the caution as you ride with Robbie Buell, the Michigan driver, chasing down Justin Bell, or attempting to chase him down, as he has since the outset of this TDK challenge at Lime Rock Park.
All right, I think we have a report. Mike Joy and Jim Pace, please.
Thank you, Bill. Jim Pace is out of the event. What ended your day?
Well, I think we had an electrical problem. A couple of times the car just switched totally off, and I flipped the switch a few times, and it hit a bump, and it would come back on and go. So that's no way to run a race, and I was afraid it might shut off in the downhill, and you just can't do that. So we brought it in, and we'll try them next time.
This racing is pretty scrappy.
Yeah, it gets real scrappy out there. This is a real rough track, and everybody out there is real competitive. And I just wish I could still be out there.
Jackson, Mississippi's Jim Pace, car number 18, in trouble here. That's Steve Gambino of Englewood, New Jersey, the wholesome bread and rolls Barber Saab. Let's take a look at what happened to him.
There he is, just sliding through the grass at that point. Just watch the back of the car. There. Now, see that rear wheel? He's broken it away from the controlling arm, so he's definitely out of the race.
Let's look at it from another angle.
Here we go, just sliding, and just the impact alone. It's not enough to damage the car a great deal, but just break those little tiny rods that are holding the wheels in place.
Last lap on the leader at 97 mile an hour average around this 8-turn, mile and a half course.
Boy, and these fellas are both trying as hard as they possibly can. Justin is fighting them off. Robbie Buell is getting back on the power as early as he can.
Remember that Justin Bell, man you see in 22, came into the race today, leading the point standings with 46 points, and Robbie Buell is in second place in the points. So this is important to both of them. There's a $100,000 bonus. Have another car off.
Can't tell what number that is, just I think one of the back markers.
Car that's car 31, and that's the one that's been lapped a couple of times, Chris McAdam out of Dallas, Texas.
And it looks
trying
like
to get it fired.
Yeah, I think he stalled at this point.
We can see that again. A little agricultural racing here.
Yeah,
McAdams.
It looks like it was just a very simple spin. He got the left rear tire onto the gravel as he entered the corner.
And that's all he's going to get for today. Thank you very much. Still trying to get it fired, but
oops.
See you later. Back up front with Santel. What a great run. He's been fighting his way up through the points.
Well, he is making this look really easy right now. He's so smooth and so much in control of this race.
He's tied for fourth in the points coming into today's battle.
And this will vault him up considerably.
Raced in Group C for Mercedes at Le Mans, at Silverstone, at Brands Hatch last year. Bernard Santel. Back in 88, he also had a Maserati out in Group A competition.
Wow, that's a rare one. Well, it appears he's taken 2 fourth places to adapt to the series, and now he's just found his little niche quite well.
Be surprised if he's the man. Look at that interval between that leader, number 20, and number 22, and that battle's still on. This Santel out in front, he's a name to be reckoned with. Oh, down to the inside, Buell trying to shot. Closing the gate was Justin Bell. Santel out in front in only his sixth race. That was a Formula 3 event at the French Grand Prix in 1982. He came home a winner. He knows how to get around these things, making it look awfully easy right now out in front. The end of the last lap, and here's the battle. It is for second position. Back and forth is John Cochran from Palm Beach, Florida. Ian Ashley is in fifth. The English driver, Buell, getting another shot, about a half lap to go to see what he can do with Justin Bell.
And I don't think Robbie can do it. He made the slightest mistake there entering that chicane. Just got a little bit sideways and wasn't able to get back on the gas until the car settled down.
There's the leader coming down for the checkered flag. Behind them comes the battle for second place. A across the line. Santel will win it. Now let's follow that battle for second place. Buell coming to the line, making a great run on the outside, but it looks like Justin Bell had him as they came to the stripe.
Truly outstanding racing. The series is just, it gets better and better all the time.
So we'll meet Bernard Santel, your winner from Switzerland. Four races, four different winners, and the TDK Challenge here at Lime Rock is won by Santel.
Car scrubbing in their tires. Taking a look at starting.